The Philippine Stock Exchange kicks off trading at 64.64, but right now it's jumping nearly 1%. We're at 65.24, up 61 points. Joining us today for his take on the markets, Edmund Lee, president of Caylum Trading Institute. Hi, Edmund. Good morning.
Hi, Mimi. How are you?
Great. So we're all waking up to a Biden lead, not yet a victory, but a lead, a very substantial lead. Do you think this market is ready or is pricing in, you know, a couple more weeks before we get the final outcome from the U.S. elections?
I think what happened over the past month is that you saw a correction already happen throughout the entire U.S., especially in the big tech. We think most of the elections and whoever wins right now is already priced into the market. And if last night was any indication, you had a pretty good insight that Biden was already going to win in the U.S. So personally, I think it's mostly priced in already in the market, and we're excited for what's to come, include especially in the emerging markets such as the Philippines.
And why do you think a Biden victory could be good for emerging markets like the Philippines?
No, I think markets are on a recovery in general, regardless of who wins in the position in the U.S., United States of America right now. As the market starts, as the economy starts to open up, and third quarter just released all over the world, third quarter actually is coming up better than expected, in our opinion. Most of them are coming from negative growth for 3Q and possibly even 4Q. But we think the market is already pricing in a 2021 recovery already happening. You're looking at more than a double-digit growth across the board for corporates. And we think that most investors and traders should be excited on that end.
Okay, but in the meantime, while we're waiting for the recovery coming in 2021, and knowing that most likely it's going to be a Biden White House, which assets do you think are going to look more attractive this time around? Are there certain asset classes or certain industries that you think could take the lead in a rally?
No questions asked. You saw your bond market outperform over the last few years. Gold outperformed significantly this year in your precious metals. And we think going for fourth quarter up until next year, you'll probably see a big lead in equities. And we think that equities is still the most important asset class and the only asset class where you'll get high returns over the next 2-3 years. And we're confident on that end. So we're really telling people to stay invested, try to learn how to stomach this volatility, because 3Q and 4Q earnings are likely still going to be negative. But all these drop-offs for us are opportunities to still accumulate and still be buying.
Okay.
Sorry.
Go ahead.
Yeah, you're looking at traditional industries. And we think the cyclicals have already seen their worst. So the ones we like are the ones that are most resilient on that end. Last time I was here, we really liked DNL. I still like DNL to today. But nonetheless, I think in general, you're seeing your power industry recover. Your toll roads have recovered. Car sales in last month picked up almost 30% month on month. So in general, I think we're seeing a good economic recovery happen. A bit slow, but nonetheless, we're on the right track.
A bit slow, but on the right track. You mentioned earnings earlier. Just wanted to share a few for those who missed it yesterday after trading hours. SM Investments actually released earnings. 9-month net income for 2020 is at $15.2 billion, down 54%. So as you mentioned, it's still down. According to its units, BDO, which is the biggest contributor, down 48%, $16.6 billion. SM Prime also down, SM Retail as well. We also got from ICTSI. ICTSI reporting for 9-month net income down by just 1% to $182.6 million. Razon, Enrique Razon, saying they're well positioned to benefit should global trade continue to show signs of recovery underpinned by stringent cost management. And finally, Metro Pacific, also from yesterday, seeing a bit of a drag there. 9-month net income down 58%. To about $5 billion. They're actually citing COVID-19 restrictions that cut toll road traffic, closed and reduced rail services, and decreased commercial and industrial demand for water and power. Power, of course, which accounted for 67%, its highest ever proportion. Water is next. So we're seeing the drags there. But here's one stock that you like. Talk to us about your blind item. Why do you like this stock? This is not a stock that we get every day. We're now flashing a 5-year chart for this.
Yeah, well, this stock has been consolidating for the last 5 years. They barely got any impact or negative impact coming from the COVID pandemic. Well, it's one of the largest telcos also in this country. We're very excited for this. Obviously, broadband and work from home have benefited them tremendously. While mobile data has lagged a bit, we think going forward, it's still very stable and very strong on that end. Mm-hmm. And we think that the biggest catalyst for this one is unlocking their mobile payment side, which is, I believe they hit a 1 trillion peso in terms of transaction volume already year to date. If you want me to talk more about this application, it's called GCash. So obviously, you know what company I'm
Edmund,
talking about.
Edmund, you gave away the answer. It's no longer blind. We can all see. Okay, but a final question. At its current price, you think there's still some upside? Because it's not cheap anymore.
I think it's still cheap.
Oh, it's still cheap. Okay.
They still have a 5.5% cash dividend yield. Mm-hmm. You're looking at a weakness, and you're looking at it stemming from high expectations going from 3Q and 4Q. So most of your resilient stocks, for example, like Pure Gold and Globe, for example, had very high expectations because of their resiliency in this pandemic. Okay. And 3Q came below that expectations. But nonetheless, we're still very excited for both spaces. And we think that they should still benefit from this pandemic. And even next year, they'll probably see growth come in.
Okay, so no more guessing. We know what stock this is. Thank you very much, Edmund, for joining us today. Always great speaking with you.
All right, thanks, Mimi.